So I hope all devil may cry freaks will join me in this bit. Cause we're gonna kill every single one of them. Now, what kind of cluster of fucks we got here? Let's dance! It is no longer painful to breathe. The poison gas must not reach this area. Nice! God damn it, nice! I hate that poison so much. What's beginning to piss me off? To me and Dante. But we're gonna kill every single demon in this game. Why? Well, because we're Dante May Cry. I think the next boss, yeah, it's gonna be Burial. Hell yeah. For some reason, don't ask me why, but Burial is my favorite boss in Devil May Cry 4. Ah, damn it. Okay. At least it didn't fall all the way down. I don't know, it's something really cool about that boss. It's not because it's the hardest or anything, it's just the boss, it's the overall. Really cool. What are you doing, Dante? You crazy buddy. Always gotta to be the center of attention. And the cocky one, huh? We all love you anyway. The grand hall. Come on. Yes, let's do it. The Nephilim Dante is ready. By eliminating the sword, the magical barrier of ice has been melted. Yes. looks like you will be able to leave the castle now. The Castlevania. The castle of Castlevania. Yeah, this area is very Lords of Shadow looking. But also reminds me of, like, Castlevania Lament of Innocence. Let's see if we can buy holy water. Oh yes. It's always good to keep at least two of those in your inventory, you know. When enemies, they piss you off, you use that and can be a great help. Yeah, when I mean Castlevania Lament of Innocence, I mean like the part of the shores, the House of Memory Remains. Oh, look at this view right here. I always love the view of the entrance. Now here, really, it really does look like Castlevania Lords of Shadow a lot. The same type of black, gothic, castle looking place. You know, Carmilla Castle. When you're reaching Carmilla, it looks just like this. Damn it, devil dogs! Ugh. Annoying.
Yeah.
I hate you. I hate you and always will hate you. Die, monster. Just die. Oh no. There he goes. Damn it. Now remember that on my Nero playthrough, I walked this area and I totally forgot about right here. There is a secret when you jump. I need to have, you see those red orbs? That is pretty much the deep, that is something up there. It's a secret room. But I need to get that, I think it's a Lucifer item that I'm gonna get after I kill the boss. After I kill the boss, I will return to this area and then I show how to get to that secret room with Dante. Hopefully we will clear the room and everything. We will see. I might edit the video and I might put it at the very end of this video, I don't know. I love the look of that moon over there. Are they coming? Oh yeah, they're coming way over there. Idiots. They just don't know when to give up, do they? Damn it, man, these persistent bastards. Go away, dog of hell. Exactly. Now we're getting really close to the boss. I always love to fight that boss with Dante, man. Because with Dante, I mean, I don't know what it is, but with Nero, you can kill him way easier rather than with Dante. Because Nero, you know, with the full upgrade of Blue Rose, he can do terrible damage to that boss. And anyway, this is the last form of him, and he's more resistant. You know, to kill him with Dante, you had to know the boss pretty well in this mode, or he can hurt you pretty bad. Let's see if I can kill it without healing. For the most part, I've been killing all the bosses without using healer items. It's a way to challenge myself too. Alright, I'm ready.
A human posing as God? How ridiculous.
You don't say.
Alright, big boy, bring it on. See what old Dante can do to you. Come on. What's up, buddy?
You can stay and die, or you can walk your ugly ass back through that gate. It's your call, pal.
I've retreated once, and will not do so again.
That's a letdown. I was hoping for a bit more than just a few sparks. Satisfied. You are set free. It don't look so big from where I'm standing. Now it's just you and me, Mr. Savior.
Lucifer, a hellish web capable of assuming an infinite, infinite number of exploding blades hover ominously in the air. My god, man, Dante's so crazy. I was trying so hard not to laugh really hard, man, in the middle of the cutscene.
Come on.
Oh, man, Dante's so over the top crazy. That cutscene always crack me up. Like, so funny, man. It's just amazing how crazy Dante can be, you know. But at the same time, I kind of feel sad because I just killed my favorite boss in the game. I don't know why, but Burial is always that most memorable boss to me from this game, since it's the first boss that we got. And when I was new to the game, I thought it was a real cool boss, you know. I usually like to cut out this mission clear status stuff, you know, because I'm trying to make this series more fast paced and make it more cinematic. But alright, let's go to that place I say I will go back to, right here in this area. You need a Lucifer, then you make the double jump and the trigger, and then hit the Lucifer attacks in mid-air, and you will reach the area.
What's up?
Exactly, just like that. And I know in another annoying mission, I'm trying to say. Now, what sometimes I do and works for me here, is that I shoot from about this distance. Okay, that worked good. And then go back. God damn it! Run! My joystick is messing with me. Got a problem with my PS controller that with the joystick, it keeps getting cancelled, the run animation. It's really, really, really annoying. There! Wow, did it the first try, huh? Nice. Nicely, Dante. Nicely done.